Hello students, this video lecture is on the subject information theory and coding, and in this class we are going to study two types of channel, binary erasure channel and noiseless channel. We are going to derive the channel capacity for both binary erasure channel and the noiseless channel. Binary erasure channel, it is one of the most important channel used in digital communication. Whenever an error occurs, the symbol will be received as Y and no decision will be made about the information, but an immediate request will be made through a reverse channel for retransmission of transmitted signal till a correct symbol is received at the output. This ensures 100% correct data recovery. Since the error is totally erased in this type of channel, it is called as binary erasure channel. The drawback of this type of channel is the requirement of reverse channel. The channel diagram of binary erasure channel is shown below. So you will be having binary inputs x1, x2, and outputs will be y1, y and y2. So x1 will be transmitted as y1 in binary erasure channel, that is for correct transmission, and if there is an error, it will be transmitted as symbol y. Then similarly, x2 will be either transmitted as y2 for correct transmission of symbol, and if there is an error, it will be transmitted as y. So at the receiver, if you are going to receive the symbol as y, it means that there is an error. Please retransmit the symbol till a correct symbol is received at the receiver. So this is the type of binary erasure channel. Channel capacity of binary erasure channel. So we'll try to derive the channel capacity for this binary erasure channel. So we'll consider the channel diagram, which is as below. So you're going to have x1, y1, then you're going to have y, then you're going to have x2, y2, and let P be the probability of error. So this will be 1 minus P, which is equal to P bar. Similarly, this P is probability of error. So y2 by x2 will be 1 minus P, which is equal to P bar. Let this be the transmitter, this be the receiver, and we'll assume certain parameters here. So let us assume that P of x1, that is input symbol probability, BW, then we'll have P of x2 will be equal to 1 minus W, which we can take it as W bar. Next, we'll try to write the channel matrix. So P of y by x matrix will be equal to, we'll have x1, x2 as the input, y1, y and y2 are the output. So we'll fill this particular channel matrix here. So P of y1 by x1 is nothing but P bar. Then this P of y by x1 is P. P of y2 by x1 is 0. Similarly, P of y1 by x2 is 0. Y by x2 is P. y2 by x2 is P bar. So this will be the channel matrix for the binary erasure channel. Now if you see this channel matrix, it is a symmetric channel. Therefore, for symmetric channel, we can write h of y by x is a constant value h, which is equal to summation j varying from 1 to s pj into log 1 by pj, or it is simply nothing but p bar into log of 1 by p bar plus p into log 1 by p. So this will be your h of y by x. Now what is h of x equal to? So h of x is nothing but input symbol probability, which is summation of I varying from 1 to 2, since it is binary, p of xi into log of 1 by p of xi. So we'll substitute the input symbol probability, which we have assumed as W and W bar. So H of X will be equal to W log 1 by W plus W bar log 1 by w bar. Let us take this as equation number 1. The joint probability matrix for the above channel P of x comma y is P of y by x into P of x. That is, we are going to multiply the channel matrix with the input symbol probability. So P of y by x from the channel diagram is given as P bar, P, 0, 0, P and P bar. So we are going to multiply this with input symbol probability P of x1 and P of x2 for the second row. So finally we are going to get a joint probability matrix P of x comma y, which is given by P bar w, P w 0, 0, P w bar, P bar w bar. So let us take this as equation number 2. Now by the property of your joint probability matrix, addition of column will give you the output symbol probability. So therefore P of y1 is addition of first column, so you are going to get it as P bar w. Similarly P of y, that is addition of second column, is P w plus P w bar, which is equal to, if you take P outside, we are going to get w plus w bar, which will be equal to P. Similarly P of y2, that is the third column element, which is P bar w bar. Now we'll find input conditional probability P of x by y, which is nothing but P of x comma y divided by P of y. So we are going to divide this second equation by the respective output probability value. So we are going to get P of x by y, which is equal to, we'll divide the element P bar w by P bar w. That is first column, 0, there is no changes. The next element is P w, and we are going to divide it by P of y, which is P. Similarly P w bar divided by P. The third column, 0 as it is. The last element P bar w bar will be divided by P bar w bar. Finally we are going to get a matrix which will be equal to, after simplification, we are going to get 1, w, 0, 0, w bar, then it is 1. So let us take this matrix as equation number 3. Now we'll find h of x by y, which is given by the equation h of x by y is equal to double summation I varying from 1 to r, j varying from 1 to s, p of xi comma yj into log of 1 by p of xi by y j. In this equation we are going to substitute this P of xi comma yj from equation number 2 and P of xi by yj from equation number 3. So after substitution we are going to get it as P bar w, which is P of xi comma yj, into log of 1 plus P w into log of 1 by w plus P w bar into log of 1 by w plus P bar w bar into log of 1. So after simplification this log 1 will be equal to 0. So finally we are going to get a equation value, which is P into w log 1 by w plus w bar into log 1 by w. So this will be h of x by y. We'll take this as equation number 4. So now we know that mutual information I of x comma y is given by I of x comma y is equal to h of x minus h of x by y. So we'll substitute this h of x, which is given by w into log 1 by w plus w bar into log 1 by w bar minus we have h of x by y, which is given. So we'll substitute here. It will be p into w log 1 by w plus w bar into log 1 by w bar. So if you take the common terms outside, we are going to get it as 1 minus p will be the common term into w log 1 by w plus w bar into log 1 by w bar. So this w into this is nothing but the term will be equal to h of x, and 1 minus p is nothing but p bar. So we can write this as p bar into h of x. So I of x comma y is given by this. We'll take this as equation number 5. Now channel capacity is given by the formula C is equal to max of I of x comma y. So we have got what is I of x equal to I of x comma y. It is nothing but p bar into h of x. So p bar is a constant term, so we can take p bar outside. It is max of h of x. So maximum of input symbol probability, so it is p bar into h of x max. So now what is h of x max equal to? Since you have two input symbols, this maximum value will be equal to log 2 is nothing but h of x max. So log 2 is nothing but 1. So we can write channel capacity C for binary erasure channel will be given by C is equal to P bar. So now we have a question here. Why we can't use I of x comma y as h of y minus h of y by x? We cannot use this formula to find mutual information because h of y is going to involve a term y which is rejected at the receiver. So we are not going to use this formula for calculation of I of x comma y in binary erasure channel. The next type of channel is noiseless channel. A channel represented by a channel matrix with one and only one non-zero element in every column is defined as noiseless channel. The rules to be followed are: each column contains only one element with other element in that column being zero. The sum of all the elements in any row is equal to unity for noiseless channel. An example is, we'll write a channel matrix first. So if you have P of B by A, which is given by the matrix, you have three inputs A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6. So we can write the matrix as, we'll have only one and one element in every column. So we'll have half 0, 0. Then we'll have half 0, 0. Then we'll have 0, 0, 0, 0. Because the sum of this row should be equal to 1. The next is 3 by 5. The other column element being 0. Then 3 by 10. The other column element being 0. Then 1 by 10. The other column element being 0. Then the last one is this. So if you try to write the channel diagram, it will be something like, you'll have A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6. So A1 to B1, the probability is half. A1 to B2, the probability is half. Then you have A2 to B3 with probability 3 by 5. A2 to B4 with probability 3 by 10. Then A2 to B5 with probability 1 by 10. And A3 to B6 with probability value 1. So this will be the channel diagram for noiseless channel. So it should meet the two rules, that is, every column should have only one and one element, and the summation of the rows should be equal to 1. Now if you are at the receiver and if you have received the symbol B1, then they must be transmitted by A1 at the transmitter. The reason for this is that when B1 is received, they cannot transmit either A2 or A3 as there is no connection from A2 and B1 and also between A3 and B1. So we can write P of AI by BJ's as AI by BJ's as either connected or not connected. So we can write A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, this matrix as we can write this as either connected or not connected. So B1 by A1 is connected, so we can write it as 1, this is 1, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and the last row will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now we can write the equivocation function h of a by b, which is given by the formula double summation I varying from 1 to r, j varying from 1 to s, p of ai comma bj into log of 1 by p of ai by bj, or we can write this also as summation. In the given example, we have I is equal to 1 to 3, j equal to 1 to s, number 1 to 6, 6 outputs, and p of ai, we can write it as p of bj into p of ai by bj, this whole term, into log of 1 by p of ai by bj. Now this term ai by bj is either equal to 1 or 0. So you will either get it as 0, this term will be either equal to 0 into log 1 plus 1 into log 0. So either of the terms will be equal to this particular form. So we can take this entire term equal to 0. So this will be equal to 0. Hence we can write h of a by b is equal to 0. That is, equivocation represents the amount of information lost in the channel due to noise is 0 here, and hence the channel becomes noiseless. Now mutual information I of a comma b is equal to h of a minus h of a by b. H of a by b is equal to 0, so we can write I of a comma b mutual information is h of a. Channel capacity C is equal to max of I of a comma b. It is equal to max of h of a, or it is simply h of a max. So in the given example, we have the maximum input as 3. So we can write C is equal to log 3. So it is equal to 1.585 bits per message symbol. Whereas in general, if we have R input symbols, for noiseless channel, then we can write C is equal to log to the base 2 of R bits per message symbol. Okay, this is a generalized case for noiseless channel with R input symbols.